sun-soaked Miami Beach provided a glistening and glamorous location for a brand new chapter in the history of show jumping. Never before has there been an event quite like this. The world-famous Florida coastline played host to the very first outing of the Global Champions League, a groundbreaking competition where the world's top riders from different countries pair up against one another. Thousands of equestrian fans, celebrities, and beachgoers gathered to discover how this fast-paced team event would unfold. An air of excitement could be felt in the idyllic sand arena, just a stone's throw from the sparkling Atlantic Ocean.
The fact that you have these horses jumping on the sand with the ocean in the background, the breeze coming by, the palm trees swaying, I mean, it's really spectacular.
The competition will be played out on some very special stages around the world, alongside the well-established Longines Global Champions Tour. Founder of the GCL, Jan Tot, has high hopes for the new move.
We wanted to go to another level, do different things for our sport. You know, for example, the dress codes with the music, more fun, but also serious sport and very easy to follow.
Uniting riders from different countries is a completely new concept within show jumping. A share of an amazing 7.5 million euros in prize money will depend on them working together and making strong tactical decisions.
Yeah, we're excited to get it off and rolling. It's the first ever event. You know, it'll take time before you start to understand sort of strategy. But I'm really excited about it and fun that it's the very first ever one in the United States.
Building on the incredible success of the long-running Global Champions Tour, now in its 11th season, GCL aims to make the sport a more attractive and thrilling experience for riders and spectators alike. Sports director Marco Denes hopes the league might even encourage a whole new audience to the sport.
We expect to show something different. It's a different kind of competition, and we hope that the public can have a different view of our sport. The hope is to create this new concept with people following the teams and to become supporters of the team, like we have in soccer or in baseball. So this is the expectation, to create a little bit interest on our sport, not only based on the individual rider, but in the concept of the team.
The concept is simple. Five riders to a team, with two competing in each event. But it's not just the very best who get to take part.
Every team has four, let's say, normal riders, and the fifth rider has to be under 25 and not in the top 30 in the ranking list. So we want to push a little bit the young riders to be part of the team, and they are in the team with the best riders of the world, so they can learn, they can have a great experience in our sport.
Yeah, it's really exciting and it's nice to be part of it from the start. I have a great team, Valkenswaard United, and tomorrow me and John are on the team, so hopefully we can get off to a strong start.
There's something new going on again in our sport, which I think is good. I mean, some different people, some different riders get involved with the sport, and I think that's very good. And I'm really looking forward how the league is going to be in the coming shows.
I think it feels really special more than anything. You know, it doesn't feel like just another show, just another week. It feels like a really, really special event. It's really exciting, you know. My team members, people that I have known over the years, but I didn't know that well. And so now we're already this week having a little camaraderie and watching each other go and getting ready for Sunday. So I'm really excited for it. I think it's going to be exciting for everyone. It's a different aspect of the sport.
Against the breathtaking backdrop of the surf and beautiful turquoise waters of the Atlantic beachfront, the Miami Dolphins cheerleaders kicked off the new league in style. The 12 teams walked the course, talked tactics, and the stage was then set for the first ever Global Champions League. Each rider hopes for a clear round and the fastest time as their scores are combined.
Well, first round is all about qualifying for round two, getting into those top eight teams to be part of that second round, part of the Global Champions League format. So starting here in the USA. And so the first of the Antwerp Diamonds, their two members are this lady, American rider Audrey Coulter, with the Copernicus Stables Alex. And then a little later on, she's teamed up with her pairing of Harry Smulders and Bokai. You can see keen interest here as all the various team members and team managers watching on.
Audrey Coulter made a solid start, but picked up four faults.
So it'll come down to a teammate then to try and keep them in the mix.
Ben Mayers rode his 12-year-old, Aristo Zed, for the Shanghai Swans, with his teammate, Jan Frederik Meyer, having already clocked up four faults in her opening round.
Ooh. I'm not sure what went wrong there. I don't think Edwina really knows either. That was unfortunate.
Well, finishes on the sixth there, so makes 80.29 on the clock. It's a team total of 10.
Local favourite Kent Farrington turned up the heat on his first attempt.
Number six in the world, great quality in the field. And well, I'm sure there's going to be the biggest cheer for these. And he would be a great man to have on your team, isn't he? He's naturally very fast. When he come into that second round, he would be the one to really have the foot to the floor and be the one you'd want to count on.
Yeah, this is a strong team. When they put this together and I looked down the lineup, I thought this was a very, very strong team. I think Kent added a stride there, but this is a very, very quick course. He goes just around the timers here. Trying to make up time here to the end of the ring. I think he's okay. He's gonna be a little close.
Just
under the time allowed, but there's our first clear round.
Yep, 75-57 gives us the first of the zero scores. Kent Farrington, Miami Glory, looking in prime spot.
And partner Georgina Bloomberg did the same.
Looks good for time. There she goes. Well, nicely done, 73-82. Puts them on a zero score, keeps them on that.
John Whitaker put in a speedy round with Lord of Arabia for Valkenswaard United. And it was down to his young teammate to prove his worth.
Bertram Allen now starts quite easy for the rider up there in the top 10 on the world rankings. He's been right up to number 5 for this young 20-year-old. He was the big winner in Paris last year, the Grand Prix. Won a string of Grand Prix, 4 or 5 big Grand Prix last season. He's already got a CV that looks like a man twice his age.
Yeah, what this kid has accomplished already in his young career is really remarkable. He's a super talent, as we all know. Some of the things he does, you just don't teach. He's just got an unbelievable feel, and again, the horses jump for him. He's got a relationship with them. Very, very fast rider. He's had some rounds with Molly Malone that were just blazing and unbeatable, and he's won all over the world.
Just really moves on around that corner as well. Just kept coming there. The way you can get away on this horse, it's phenomenally fast.
Little rub there. He's good on time.
There we go, 74-34. So it's heating up the battle between Miami and Valkenswaard. There's John. In deep contemplation, watching intently. Go on.
It wasn't such a successful round for Faleh Suwayed Al-Ajami from Qatar.
Yeah, that was a shame, but this is going to really put them in a difficult situation.
And coupled with some time penalties from his teammate Sheikh Ali bin Khalid Al Thani. The pair were one of four to be knocked out of the competition. Then it was the turn of America's Laura Kraft. She rode her nine-year-old Cavalier for the Rome Gladiators.
Since she was on ponies, everything she rode just jumped for her, and it still holds true for this top level. Jumping a beautiful round so far. That vertical at the end of the ring is a little difficult. The horses seem to just get their eye off it. She's just going to make the time. Oh, and the last jump. That was a shame. That was a nice round.
Well, it's a new one that's been stepping up this season, which is good to see.
Leopold Van Asten from Monaco Aces picked up five faults on his nine-year-old VDL, grew up Miss Untouchable. So it was up to Daniel Blumen from the US to try and boost their chances of success.
A little rub there, but it stays in the cups. Again, rub or two through the triple, but they stay up.
Sitting in that eighth spot at the moment.
Whoa. You hear the crowd there. They even noticed something was a little wrong there. And he's maybe going to have a time fall.
Just enough.
Just made it.
Just enough. Goes clear there. So leaves them on the five and in with a chance.
At the end of the first round, Miami Glory topped the scoreboard, closely followed by Valkenswaard United. Both Shanghai Swans and Kashkai's Charms just about made it in the top eight, ensuring their spot in round two. Top international riders remained in the Global Champions League after an initial 12 teams had completed their first round. Laura Kraut and Laura Rennick were one of the eight teams battling it out into the second round. Like all the riders in the Global Champions League, they were filled with trepidation facing this new team sport.
It's a bit of the unknown for us as well at the moment. I think this is the first event, I think, speed's going to come into the equation, and as I say, we're both on reasonably young horses. They're both naturally quick, so hopefully if speed is an issue then we will be okay, but we're a little bit unsure, aren't we?
No, exactly.
Although there are five riders in all the teams, just two compete here on the glorious Miami sands. As the season progresses, all the team members will get their chance in the saddle.
It's a great addition to and already the team sport. So, you know, for the Nations Cup, it's still important for us to ride for our countries, but then we have this new concept of having our own team, which is really fun.
All the teams are working out tactics for this new event, and the horse they choose for the conditions is one of the most important decisions they'll make. Laura Kraut has high hopes for Cavalier.
She's young, she's only nine, and just started at this level, but she's quick. And being that this is the first competition ever of this team sort, I'm not sure how much is going to rely on speed or not. So I wanted to make sure that I had a horse that I knew could be quick if we needed to break a tie or whatever.
Laura Rennick has gone for a higher risk strategy with her horse, MHS Washington.
She's only eight. This is her first experience at this level, so it's going to be a bit of an eye-opener, but she can be quick when she needs to be. And the same with Laura, you know, it's a little bit, we're not quite sure exactly what we need, but we hopefully we've got the right tools for the job.
Whilst the sandy conditions call for the right horses, for the riders and the sunbathers on the beach alike, this unique venue is the perfect spot to showcase this groundbreaking team event.
you can see probably behind us is literally where we compete, just over there. I mean, it's really surreal. This is my first time here. Obviously, Laura was here last year, so she's perhaps a bit more used to it than I am. But it's an amazing venue, and amazing, like, for the public to be here and just to wander up from the sea and just watch us do our thing. It's incredible.
Round two of the Global Champions League was a completely different course in design, allowing for a lot more speed and a real run to the last fence. The top eight teams walked the course once again, looking for ways to save valuable seconds while going for a clear. Laura Crouch, riding for the Rome Gladiators, was first in the ring. Altogether, the team had clocked up 9 faults in round one.
Surprise Farms Cavalli, a 9-year-old for the Rome Gladiators. She's teamed up with Laura Rennick, who could really play into Laura Rennick's hands here, as she's a very fast rider. But different strategy this time, as you say, Jimmy. They've got a chance here to accelerate. Different type of course, asking different questions.
Yeah, for sure. And several places he gave you the inside option. He gave you, there's a spot to the triple combination. Here again, there's a opportunity right here where Laura's taking the inside turn here, off the inside turn. That's why you see again the 7 strides with the inside turn. They do the 7 if you were to go around, then you do 6 strides there. Neat back on this jump. Little rub there. Your 8 strides. Her plan was there, do the 8 strides and make the inside turn. And I think the horse anticipated that left turn and just jumped down right into that top rail.
Well, Laura Crouch means the score goes up to 13 for the team. Adds the 4 there for Laura, so team total of 13. So again, it all changes around because they now drop below. Rome Gladiators drop below Cashcare's Charms and Shanghai Swans.
And partner Laura Rennick finished in style with a strong clear round.
This was the lady who led us off in round one, Audrey Coulter.
Yep, she's being a little conservative. Yeah, beautiful clear round at a time of 57.93.
Yeah, and produces the clear, so the team total for the Antwerp Diamonds staying on the 4 and keeps them in one fence of the teams on the 0 score at the moment.
Leopold Van Aston jumped first for the Monaco Aces. But a fence down put the pressure on teammate Daniel Blumen to go fast and clear in order to keep them in with a chance of success.
Daniel Blumen producing a clear in round one. On Believe, team total of 9 at this stage. Skylar Riley there also on the team for later venues. Interesting hearing the roars from the crowd, because most of the people here have never seen this sport before, which is great.
I think they're really getting the feeling. You hear him there.
Now he goes wide around there, but keeps on running. And running and running and running. Now it'll be interesting to see how that pays on time, 60.12. That's not too far away, and gives himself plenty of room to get to the last, so keeps him on a clear. Team total of 9 then. Well, we're back with the Valkenswaard United team. Emily Moffitt there at the forefront. She'll be the young rider, and this is their more senior rider, John Whitaker, to lead them off. He did exactly what you'd expect from John, clear in the first round with Lord of Arabia. There's Harry Smulders watching on for the Antwerp Diamonds. John teamed up with Bertram Allen, and that's a little bit of a dream team, isn't it, Jimmy?
Yeah, it really is. Either what we talked earlier about who you'd want to go first and who you'd want to go second, with John and Bertram, I don't think it really matters. Either one of them could be an anchor rider on any team. Both have although Bertram is such a young rider, he's got so much experience at his age, and John, for sure, a legend of the sport. Probably nobody out here has as much experience as John does.
I don't think you'd ever find another sport with 40 years between the two team members, which is great to be able to draw on that. John as ever draws the crowd.
But it stays up, doesn't even rub it.
Now this to keep them in it, and it is clear, and it's a decent time as well, 60.43. Smile for Emily on the stands as it keeps Valkenswaard United on a zero score. John Whitaker, he's done his stuff, Jimmy.
Yeah, and that really put the heat on the next team.
Now Antwerp Diamonds, Harry Smulders. Now this team score of 4 at the moment. Harry with the 10-year-old Bokai. John Whitaker there, who's done his bit for his team. Yeah, go on, let me in, you know.
With the pressure to get a clear, and John Whitaker watching closely from the sidelines, Harry Smulders needed to put in a strong performance for the Antwerp Diamonds.
So they're just one fence off the Valkenswaard United.
Finishing on 4 faults, they were hot on the heels of the leading team.
John Whitaker, Emily Moffitt watching there, the guide John Whitaker. Bertram Allen is his man on course. Quiet, easy 4. Now, a 0 score for the win. Simple as that, really, isn't it?
Rail.
Well, that puts it close again, so that keeps it tight.
And the thing is, remember, we probably still won't have a jump off, even though two teams will end up on the 4. It goes to time.
It goes to time. So we start looking. We've got Antwerp Diamonds, if you like, in the clubhouse, finished off on the 4 at 118.59. Miami Glory with 1 still to come.
And you see Bertram there. Quick turn back. He knows the format. He's trying to be a very fast 4.
Yeah.
Ooh, he's trying to be quick.
It's going to be time that's going to decide this. He keeps it clean to the last. 52.72. He's lightning fast.
Very smart ride. Very, very smart. He had to
do that because so keeps them on the 4 and final time. Of 113.16.
As the only other team to both get no faults in the first round, within hundredths of a second of John Whitaker and Bertram Allen, Miami Glory had a lot resting on their second round. But a mistake early on could prove costly.
Well, this puts the pressure on both his teammate Georgina and also puts in the minds of Valkenswaard United as well. Puts the pressure on to keep it clear and keep ahead.
So for teammate Georgina Bloomberg, it was all to play for.
Ken Farrington, her teammate, talking it through. He's one of the fastest in the book. He's giving her those final instructions of where we're going to go. Last rider it comes down to for the Miami Glory.
For Georgina, clear round isn't enough.
No.
Big gallop to this big oxer. Oh, and she gets away with it. And 7. Oh, that was... Yeah, I think everything was going just right, but I think the 7 strides and trying to do the inside turn was a bit of a gamble.
Well, we'll give them the 4 to add the score, so a team total of 8 will put them in 3rd place in the end for the Miami Glory. It's a win for Valkenswaard United, John Whitaker and Bertram Allen.
Yep, so we've got the grandfather and the young kid come out on top. It's pretty cool. You see the oldest rider and the youngest rider actually win our event today.
was great to have a podium finish. We were obviously hoping to win. It's, you know, the launch of the league, and it's our hometown as a team, so we were really hoping to pull off a win, but we're very happy with third.
I was very satisfied, and we came from fifth position or fourth position, so and we moved up. So you cannot afford anything in this class because it will change the leaderboard very quickly.
Yeah, it was a great competition, great to win the first one actually. Yeah, it was a bit nerve-wracking watching Bertram when he had number two down. But he's naturally fast, and he did a great round. He kept it together and he did a great job.